Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today we are going to just show you, really quickly how to graph numbers on a number line. We've done it before. I just want to remind you because it comes up again in this time of the quarter. This is a set of numbers. You see this symbol here at the end? That's set notation. That just means we have a set, and all that means is that we're considering these numbers all together. That makes them a set. Anyway, if I want to put zero on my number line here, and I want to graph negative 2. When you want to plot something, what you want to do is put a point there. And then you have to label it as negative 2. If you do this on the Math Excel program, you're going to point on that and drag it and drop it in the right place. Negative 2 is left of 0. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is to the right of 0. And to graph it, we actually put a coordinate point there. 3 is 1, 2, 3. This is negative 4 from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Remember, all the negatives are to the left and all the positives are to the right. And then negative 1 from 0, we're going to go backwards and negative 1. So that would be the point, all those points plotted on a number line. I wanted to do another one. This is a really brief video, but I want to do another one using decimals and fractions. So let's say I randomly make this one 0. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We'll make this one 0, just so I have a kind of a starting point. Again, this is a set of numbers. You can see I use the set notation to enclose them. Negative 2.25. Well, let's say that this is negative 2. This is negative 1. This is negative 3. So where would negative 2.25 go? We know it's around negative 2. Is it just to the right of it or just to the left of it? Well, 2.25 absolute value-wise is a little greater than 2. So it's further away from 0. Here's our 0. So negative 2.25 could be right here. I'm going to write that above because it doesn't really fit in there. Okay, that's about a quarter. It's not exact, but we know it's a pretty close. What about this one, 1/5? Think about the distance between 0 and 1, and if you could divide that up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, into 5 parts, then 1/5 is 1 of those 5 parts away. So 1/5 is right there close to 0. 4.75, well, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4.75 has a greater absolute value than 4, so it's further away from 0. Not all the way over here to 5, but this says halfway is there, then halfway between that is the 0.75. That would be 4.75. And finally, negative 16/3. How would you do something like that? Well, what you could do is change it into a decimal or change it into a mixed number. What is negative 16/3 as a mixed number? All we have to do is say 3 goes into 16. It's negative because it's negative overall. 3 goes into 16 5 times with 1 left over. So we're talking about negative 5 and 1/3. So here's 3, here's negative 4, here's negative 5. If this was negative 6 and I thought about that as being in thirds, I'm negative 5 and an additional 1/3 back. So right here at negative 5 and a third, or negative 16/3. If you have trouble graphing something, making it into a mixed number or a decimal is going to be helpful for you for doing that. Have a fantastic